Good morning, students. How are you? And once again, I'm back with this lesson of Evelyn Glennie. As I already told you that she was working very hard to learn the music in spite of her deafness. She was working day and night to learn music. And she has got many achievement also. And the motto of her life was, if you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. So this was the motto of her life, which I already told you, that if you will work hard and you know where you are going, you will get there. That means where there is a will, there is a way. If you really wanted to do something, you will definitely reach to that goal. And she got right to the top. That means she was number one. She got the topmost position, and as I told you, she became multi-percussionist. That means she could play. She was the master of some thousand instruments like drums, and then congo. Okay, and she was having an hectic international schedule. That means she was having a busy international schedule. And she also told you that she was having problem with the bushy man because it was difficult to see them lip sync. But then also she tried to best so that she, through their eyes and through their face, she was able to read whatever they wanted to say. And now we are here in paragraph 8. I also told you that she was telling that music pours through my part of the body, like it tingles in the skin, through cheekbone, through skin, through hair. She was able to feel the music. She explained one of her experiences with you people, that when she was playing the xylophone, she can sense the sound passing up the stick into her fingertips. That means through her fingertips, she was able to feel the vibration and can hear the xylophone. By leaning against a drum, she can feel the resonance flowing into her body. So in this way, she was able to learn the music. In the picture, you can see that how engrossed she is while playing the xylophone. Now, we are coming to the eighth part. We are coming to this part of your lesson. Here, paragraph 8. Not surprisingly, Evelyn delights her audience. Now, children, her audience also used to enjoy. It's not surprising. Why it's not surprising? Whatever she used to do, she used to do with her whole, with her soul and heart. Evelyn delights her audiences. In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society prestigious Soloist of the Year award. Now, she was presented this award, was the most highest award at that time. You can see that she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year award. And somebody told her that God may have taken her hearing, but he has given her back something extraordinary. What was the extraordinary thing? In spite of her deafness, she reached to the height. She had learned music. She was doing now the solo performance, and she was having a busy international schedule. So, master percussionist, one of the master percussionists, James Blades, You can see here one of the master percussionist was there, and what was the name of that person? James Blades. He only told her that God has taken her hear, extra, he has taken her hearing, but he has given her back something very extraordinary. What we hear, she feels. That means whatever we hear in the form of music, she used to feel the vibration through her different parts of body far more deeply than any of us. That means, and she used to have a, she used to feel in a more deeper way compared with the ordinary or other human being. And that was the reason, the more beautiful manner she was grasping the music, the more in a very nice manner, in a more beautiful manner she was presenting in front of her audience. Evelyn confesses that she is something of a workaholic. That means workaholic means that continuously she was working very hard to reach at the top. She rarely used to take a rest. She rarely used to waste her time. I've just got to work. Her motto of life was just got to work. That means every time she used to think of working. Often harder than classical musician. She used to work more harder than the classical musician. But the rewards are enormous. And she got the rewards also. Okay. And enormous means great. So she got the greatest reward. Like she was giving the solo performance, and she was having a busy, hectic international stage show she was doing. Apart from the regular concerts, Evelyn also gave free concerts in prison and hospital. Now see how nice she was. That apart from the regular concerts, she used to give free concerts in prisons and hospitals. So for the patients, she used to go to the hospital to entertain with her musical performance, and in prison also she used to go. She also gives high priority to classes for young musicians. Now definitely it is experienced musician were given much preference, but she used to give priority to the young musician, the newcomers. Anne Richlin of the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children says she is shining inspiration for deaf children. They see that there is nowhere that they cannot go. Now children, she is an inspiration for deaf children also. Earlier they used to feel that they have to go nowhere, there is nothing in their life to learn, but she used to go and she used to share her experience with them and motivate them that they can do a lot in their life. Evelyn Glennie has already accomplished more than most people twice her age. So what Evelyn Glennie used to do? She used to complete what most people used to do twice her age. She has brought percussion to the front of the orchestra. Earlier, percussionists used to stand at the side of the stage. But due to her wonderful performance, she was given the space in the front, in the center, in the front of the stage, and demonstrated that it can be a very moving. And she used to play in such a way that everybody heart was used to moved by seeing her wonderful performance. She has given inspiration to those who are handicapped. Now she has become inspiration, a motivational force for those who were handicapped. People who look to her and say, if she can do it, I can. Now, what motivation she used to give to the people, to the handicapped people or to the deaf people, they used to think, if she can do it, then why can't I? Even I can do it. So she was a motivational for many person. And not the least, she has given enormous pleasure to million. And million of people, they were entertained by her. So she used to encourage this young musician by giving high priority to their class. She used to give free concerts in prisons and hospital. And she has brought orchestra to the front. And then She was first of all workaholic. She was workaholic. So you can see in this lesson, we have seen that how nicely Evelyn Glennie, in spite of her deafness, she has become world's famous musician. And she is an inspiration to the handicapped. She has given great pleasure to the million of people. So without hearing, she used to function with ease. She used to speak fluently, and with the feeling of the vibration from different part of her body, she has reached the place where hardly anyone reaches. Now, why this was happening in her life? Because she was a determined, she was a lady, she was a girl with full of determination. She could have led the normal life, but she had a thirst for achieving something in her life. And that's why she never looked at the back. She was moving ahead, working very hard, as we know that she was very, very, very workaholic person. At the age of 17, she was learning music when other girls enjoy their teenage. At the age of 17, she went to the Royal Academy of Music in London, and she started learning. It was Ron Forbes who spotted her potential, and he tuned two large drums to different notes. He said to Evelyn not to listen through her ears but through some other way. So in a way, Ron Forbes was the godfather. She used to play for the regular concerts. She also gave free concerts in prison and hospital. So you can see, she was determined to live a normal life, and the deafness of her body did not hinder her learning power. She wanted to learn more and more. She wanted to say this thing: if you work hard and know where you are going, you will definitely go there. Such were the wordings of Evelyn Glennie. So they both used to work very hard. Now, so it was Evelyn herself, she said this words, that her hard work lies behind her success. She said that if you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. And she reached to the top. She confessed this also. She said that she has just got to work often harder than classical musician. So she is an inspiration to the handicapped, because she herself is deaf. Being handicapped herself, she has brought percussion to the front of the orchestra, and she has shown to the world that it can be very moving, and handicap can never become a hindrance if a person want to learn. It was the deaf children who finds her a shining inspiration. They can see, they used to feel that there is nowhere that they cannot go. If they really work hard like Evelyn, they can also achieve their aim. So with hard work and determination, Evelyn Glennie has become a multi-percussionist. She scored the highest marks in the history of the academy also. And first of all, at the end of her 3-year course at the academy, she captured most of the top awards. She was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's famous Soloistic of the Year award. So this proves that where there is a will, there is a way. And with this, I end my video here. Thank you, and have a nice day ahead.